Hello everyone. In this video I will show you the new way to start an activity for result. So this is a simple application. It contains two activities. The first is called main activity and the second is called form activity. So the main activity contains a button. And when we click on this button, we need to start the second activity, which is called form activity. So here for the moment, we will use the start activity for result to start the second activity. But here you can see that start activity for result is crossed out, which means that it is deprecated. So I will show you later how to replace this method with the new method. So when we return from the form activity, we will execute the onActivityResult method. So what we will do here is that if the result is result OK, we will modify the title of this activity. And also we will display a toast with the text title modified. But if the result is not result OK, for example the user clicks on the cancel button, then we will display a toast with the text operation cancelled. So this is the old method. Now let's test the application. And here we have this main activity with this button. Now when we click on this button, we will see the second activity, which is called form activity. So this form activity contains an edit text in which we need to provide the new title. So let's say for example, welcome. Then if I click on OK, we can read this toast, title modified, and the title has been modified. Now if I click on modify the title, then here I can provide any value. Now if I don't click on the OK button, but instead I click on this cancel button, we can see operation cancelled and the title has not been modified. So now let's go back to the source code. And let's use the new method to start an activity for result. So first of all, we need to put all of this method as a comment. So let's do this. Now I need to create a variable called ActivityResultLauncher. So I will create it just here. And I can initialize this variable using the method RegisterForActivityResult. Now here, as you can see, this class is not recognized, so we need to import it. And now it has been imported. Now this method, the RegisterForActivityResult, requires two parameters. So the first parameter is this, and the second parameter is this. Now we need to import this parameter, and also we need to import this class. So let's select this first option. Also, we need to import this class. But this second parameter is an abstract class. So we need to implement all the methods of this class. So we can just click on this, then implement methods. So here we can just click on OK. Now we need to implement this method called onActivityResult. So first I will modify the name of this object. I will just call it ActivityResult. And now we need to read the result code and also we need to read the intent. And now we need just to copy the code of our old onActivityResult method. So let's come here and let's copy these statements. Now let's paste them just here. Now that we have replaced the old onActivityResult method with the new method, we need just to modify the startActivityResult method with the new method as well. So let's copy the name of this variable. Now let's go to startActivityForResult. And here we need to put this statement as a comment. Then we need to use the variable that we have created, which is called ActivityResultLauncher, .launch. So this is all what we have to do if we want to use the new way to start an activity for result. Now let's restart our application to test it. Now let's click on modify the title. And here let's provide a new title. Now if I click on OK, I obtain this toast title modified, and this is the new title. Now let's click on modify the title again. Now if I provide any value, then I just click on this cancel button. I will obtain this toast with operation cancelled, and the title does not change. You can find the source code that I used in this video in the first command. Finally, thank you very much for watching, and please subscribe to the channel.